A large portion of our movement series focuses on correct posturing. We don't mean selfies at the gym or posing at the crag. That's a different video. This is body posturing and positioning for improved climbing. Before we discuss movement, let's break down the most balanced position on the wall. Posture, or the act of posturing, is the term we'll use for the most basic and efficient body position. With proper posturing, the effect of gravity will transfer weight from your arms to the lower body. This process should engage our biggest, strongest weight-bearing muscle group in the legs, taking your body weight off of the hands. Posturing is also a way to prevent injuries in your shoulders due to overuse or overstress. Not engaging with the scapula puts stress on your connective tissues in your shoulders. The first component often involves maintaining straight arms or perhaps bent arms, or trying to not sag the shoulders. From there, pull your chest in close to the wall. Sagging when maintaining straight arms doesn't make use of the back muscles, causing increased weight on your fingers and forearms. With gravity constantly present, we should make use of our muscles, or else they become dead weight. The second component to proper posturing is placing your hips or center of mass close to the wall. As mentioned, this goes along with arching your back or pulling your hips into the wall. The third component is to maintain weight onto platforms or footholds as you accomplish the next movement. Old school climbers used to say the phrase, "climb proud" or "climb proudly" when moving through a crux. This means the hips are in, the back is engaged, and the chest is up and forward, as compared to an inefficient, sagging posture. There is a time and place to sag your shoulders and not set your scapula or have your hips close to the wall. This is when you're looking for your feet while on the wall. In order for you to bring your feet up, you must first be able to see the foothold. This is when you sag your shoulders, push your hips away from the wall, lower your heels, and survey what's below you. Remember to come back to the posturing position before moving towards the next handhold. See our videos on the process of movement for more information.